Children have the right to feel safe and be safe all the time, but safety doesn't just happen. In recent years, a number of inquiries have uncovered just how many children have been harmed or abused in organisational settings when organisations don't have the right culture, systems, processes and understanding to prevent child abuse. The Child Safe Standards are a set of mandatory requirements that organisations must act on to protect children and young people from harm and abuse. Victoria has had mandatory standards for a number of years, and they apply to most organisations that work or volunteer with children. Organisations covered by the standards include businesses, clubs, not-for-profit or volunteer organisations, and government agencies. From July 2022, new Child Safe Standards apply to these organisations to help us keep strengthening our efforts to keep children safe.
At the Commission for Children and Young People, every day we oversee investigations into allegations of sexual, physical and psychological abuse of children in organisations. We know that the impact of childhood trauma stays with many children for the rest of their lives. Victoria's Child Safe Standards are now more aligned with the national principles for child safe organisations. This integrates what we learned from the Royal Commission into institutional responses to child sexual abuse. The 11 standards have clear guidance for organisations with minimum requirements to keep children safe. This includes policies and procedures you need to have and actions you need to take to ensure that all children and young people are safe in your organisation. We also understand that every organisation is different. The steps your organisation need to take will depend on your characteristics and your role with children. You might be a large business with a high level of responsibility for children, or you might be a small volunteer-run group that only provides some services for children. Either way, you need to meet the minimum requirements for each of the 11 standards. It is important to remember that all of the standards and the minimum requirements are legal obligations. This means that your organisation must implement them all. You can't pick and choose.
Let's quickly run through the 11 Child Safe Standards. Child Safe Standard 1 requires that organisations establish a culturally safe environment in which the diverse and unique identities and experiences of Aboriginal children and young people are respected and valued. Child Safe Standard 2 means child safety and wellbeing is embedded in organisational leadership, governance and culture. Child Safe Standard 3 requires that children and young people are empowered about their rights, participate in decisions affecting them and are taken seriously.
Child Safe Standard 4 means families and communities are informed and involved in promoting child safety and wellbeing. Child Safe Standard 5 means equity is upheld and diverse needs respected in policy and practice. Child Safe Standard 6 means people working with children and young people are suitable and supported to reflect child safety and wellbeing values in practice.
Child Safe Standard 7 requires the organisation to have processes for complaints and concerns that are child-focused. Child Safe Standard 8 means staff and volunteers are equipped with the knowledge, skills and awareness to keep children and young people safe through ongoing education and training. Child Safe Standard 9 means that the organisation's physical and online environments promote safety and wellbeing while minimising the opportunity for children and young people to be harmed.
Child Safe Standard 10 means implementation of the Child Safe Standards is regularly reviewed and improved. Child Safe Standard 11 means policies and procedures document how the organisation is safe for children and young people. A child safe organisation considers the diverse circumstances of each child. It recognises some children are more likely to be at risk of harm and abuse than others and responds according to their different needs. Upholding equity and respecting diverse needs are relevant considerations in implementing all standards. Organisations need to give attention to the vulnerability and needs of individual children, including those children living with disability, children from a culturally and linguistically diverse background, those children and young people unable to live at home, LGBTQI children, Aboriginal children, children of different religions, and children who have experienced past trauma. Learning more about these children can help you protect them from abuse and harm. There is a specific standard that requires organisations to establish a culturally safe environment in which the diverse and unique identities and experiences of Aboriginal children and young people are respected and valued. Being able to express their cultural identity makes Aboriginal children stronger and safer. It is important because when Aboriginal children do not feel safe to be themselves and express their individual culture, the risk they will be abused by others increases, and it may reduce their willingness to report that abuse. Protecting children from abuse and harm requires effort from the whole community. Organisations need to help parents, carers, families and communities play their part in protecting children by involving them in the organisation and providing them with information to understand their approach to child safety.
We know the overwhelming majority of people who work with children have their best interests at heart. And we've seen many organisations put in great work to make sure the children they work with are valued and respected, protected from harm, and empowered to speak up about safety concerns. But it can be too easy for people to think that child abuse in organisations is something that only happened in the past, or that could never happen in their organisation, meaning they do not put in the effort needed to think about what kinds of risks may exist and how they can be managed. It can be too easy to act on outdated myths about child abuse, to think that what children say is less reliable than what adults say, or that only certain types of adults can pose risks to children. And it can be too easy to get your child safety policies and systems in place, but not realise that child safety has to be constantly reviewed, refreshed, and embedded in your organisation. Based on what we see in our work at the Commission, I can tell you, your work to implement the Child Safe standards is as important as ever.
At the Commission for Children and Young People, we are here to support you and have a range of information, guidance and resources available. Depending on the type of organisation you work in, such as schools or early childhood education services, you can also contact one of the co-regulators the Commission works with to enforce the standards. Take action now by visiting the Commission's website to better understand your obligations under the standards. Your actions will help protect children and young people from harm and abuse.